Today's session I have called The Harvest because whatever hard work we did for the past few days, we are going to reap it now. A lot of results will be proved today using whatever hard work we have done for the past few days. One of the landmark results will be the invariance of the adjunction space. The details we will see in the what follows now, okay? So the first thing is three results which relate the weak deformation retract, the deformation retract, and strong deformation retract. We know that these things are one, you know, stronger than the other, but when they can be equal, that kind of thing we want to see. So the first thing says is, you take a cofibration from A to X. A is a subspace which is closed, and A to X is a cofibration. Okay, then the first thing is that if A is a weak deformation retract, then it is a strong deformation retract. The only part is what we need. If it's a deformation retract, it's a weak deformation retract, it's obvious, right? So if A is a weak deformation retract of X, if and only if it is a deformation retract of X. The next thing is, namely B, if A happens to be contractible, then as if the entire subspace A can be thought of as a single point homotopically. So the correct thing is to go modulo A, namely identify the entire space to A and take the quotient space. The quotient map itself becomes a homotopy equivalence. So this you would expect always, but it is not always true. It is true under A to X cofibration. So nice basis, this is true. Okay. Third one is slightly a different variation of the same phenomena. Instead of quotienting out A, you look at A as it is, but take homotopies relative to A. Then can you say that contractibility of A will imply, you know, anything which is homotopic will be relative homotopic to A? That's again not true. Meaning you need, this time you need even stronger hypothesis, namely a point A naught, wherever you want to concentrate the whole of A, should be a strong deformation retract. If A is contractible, A naught is a deformation retract of A, but may not be strong deformation retract. If it is strong deformation retract, then the inclusion map of X A naught to X A is a homotopy equivalence. So it is like all homotopy information now inside A, wherever you want to control A, can be obtained by just controlling point A naught. Okay? So these things are themselves very useful in homotopy theory. So we are developing the homotopy theory here, you see, from smaller chunks to larger chunks. Okay? So let us go through the proofs of this, which are now more or less one line proofs, because hard work is already done. Okay, so how to say something is a deformation retract when it is a weak deformation retract? Okay, so given a homotopy inverse R naught from X to A, remember the inclusion map is a homotopy equivalence, is the same thing as saying that A is a weak deformation retract. So R naught is the inverse of R naught, inverse R naught, the homotopy inverse of R naught for the inclusion map eta. Eta is a homotopy equivalence. It's same thing as saying A is a weak deformation tract by definition. So take R naught as its inverse. Okay. Let there be a homotopy from R naught composite theta to identity, because these two are homotopic, because this is inverse of that. So let F be such a homotopy from A cross I to A between R naught composite theta and identity of A. Okay. With this much of thing, we can get a deformation retract. The key is use that A to X is a cofibration. So go back to your definition of a homotopy extension property. Okay, namely that is what introduced in figure 4. So I will reconstruct it here below. So what I have is A cross 0 to X cross 0, the inclusion map. Here I have put, instead of G in the original thing, I have put R naught here now. This is the inverse of, homotopy inverse of eta. And F is the corresponding homotopy from A cross I to I. So you take this commutative diagram. This is automatic. That implies, because this is a cofibration, that is homotopy extension property, implies there is a homotopy H from X cross I to A, which fits this diagram. Namely, restricted to A cross I, it is F. Restricted to X cross 0, it is R naught. Okay, so that is what I am going to use now. So,
hello, sir.
Would
you explain the diagram one more time to say why it is a homotopy extension property it shows?
A is a homotopy extension property is the assumption beta. You see that this is cofibration is the blanket assumption on the entire theorem.
Okay.
Cofibration means what? Homotopy extension property is there for every space and every map and so on. This you can choose. As soon as you choose this, such that this diagram commutative, there is a map here. That is the conclusion. So F is extended to H, that is a homotopy extension property. Okay, so I'm going to use that. So you have H from X cross I to A, such that H restricted to this A cross I, eta, through eta cross identity is F, restricted to X cross 0, it's R naught. But then H defines homotopy between R naught and identity of A. Because HX0 is R naught, H of X1 will be F of X1. So that will be R naught. Okay. So you have this also implies that if you take eta composite R naught, okay, eta composite R1, we know is homotopic to eta composite R naught, but eta composite R naught is eta composite identity is identity of X. So we have got that R naught is a deformation retract. Okay. So the weak deformation retract became a deformation retract as soon as A to X is a cofibration. Alright. So that is the key here. Similar thing will be done for the second part also. What is the second part here? If A is contractible, quotient map X to X by A will be a homotopy equivalence. Okay. So let us go through this one. F is a मैं फ्रॉम ए क्रॉस आई टू ए इज होमोटोपी ऑफ द आइडेंटिटी मैप विथ ए कॉन्स्टेंट मैप ए नॉट ऑल पॉइंट ए गोइंग टू ए नॉट इज अ पॉइंट ऑफ ए दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ए इज कंट्रैक्टेबल आइडेंटिटी मैप ऑफ ए इज होमोटोपिक टू अ कॉन्स्टेंट मैप दिस टाइम इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग ए हियर आई टेक दिस स्पेस टू बी एक्स हियर Actually, in the original general, for any space y, any map g like this and so on is there. So instead of that y, I am putting this time here, I am putting y put x itself. And this map will be taken to be identity map. So that is what I am talking figure 4, but I am reconstructing it here. Again, you get a capital H here to fit the diagram. Here again I am using that A is a Phi vibration. So this time it is this map. Here it became I X and I instead of R became identity map. Restricted to A, it is homotopic to a constant map. F A comma 1 will be a constant map here. So that is a homotopy F. This homotopy data, this data for Phi vibration gives rise to this conclusion. Namely, there is an H here which fitting the diagram. Okay. So what is the meaning of that now? Restricted to H restricted to 0 or H restricted to X cross 0 is identity because it's identity. Restricted to F cross I, it is A cross I, it is F. Okay. So what are the properties of this H? Okay, H1 of XA, which is H of X1, H of X1 here, has the property that F of, this is F of A comma 1, which is a constant map A0, which means all of the points, that's, if A belongs to A, then they are going to a single point. Therefore, this map H1 factors down through the map Q, quotient map X to X by A, gives you a map from X by A to X. So that is what I'm calling as a G1. Okay, because under this H1, all the points of A are going to a single point, which is the single point identification X by A is all, this is one single class. So this is a G1 is X by A to X, because H1 is X to X, okay? Which is just, I am writing what is the property of G1? G1 is H1 is equal to G1 composite Q. Also, the homotopy 2 cross H now if you take, first take, now see, H is from X cross I to X, then follow it by Q. Okay. That means I have quotiented out by all the points here. This also factors down to define a homotopy from X by A cross I to X by A. The points of A which are been identified here, they are identified here also. That is, what you have is Q cross identity composite with G is the same thing as Q cross H. Okay, so what is this map G? G is from, again, now identity map X cross A to X to X becomes a identity map from X by A to X by A. Okay, that is the starting point. Okay, and the end is Q cross G1, Q composite G1. So it is a homotopy between identity and Q composite, which means Q has G1 as its right inverse. I put a homotopy inverse. Right? And that is enough to conclude that this is a homotopy equivalence. The G1 composite Q is this H1. which is homotopic to identity. The last one is a special case. What is the definition of last one? If you have, instead of arbitrary contractibility, in arbitrary contractibility, you have just homotopy from identity to the constant map. Which is strong deformation retract means this homotopy is relative to A naught. The same argument will give you same argument, same G and so on, extra, all these things work in the same case, but now I have the homotopy being constant on A naught, so that is extra thing here, so that will tell you that H1 is a relative homotopy, that means the homotopy from H1 to the inverse is constant on A naught, that's all. Okay, whatever homotopy you have got there is a relative homotopy on A naught, with respect to A naught. But it will conclude that XA to XA, okay, you don't have to actually, you don't have to, in this case, you don't have to go down to X by A at all. As soon as I, you know, halfway here in this here, before going down, as soon as you got this one, this H1 is homotopy inverse relative to A. Okay. So stronger hypothesis gives you an easier conclusion, a stronger conclusion. Okay. Next, so now you know many books just say it's contractible, therefore you can collapse it and so on without giving any proof. I have given you a proof, and the proof is correct only if A to X is a cofibration. In fact, we will have easy examples when this is not a cofibration. This is not a fact. You can't just take X by A and say that it is a homotopy equivalent ordinal X. Okay. So next result: take a map from X to Y. It is a homotopy equivalence if and only if X is a deformation retract of MF. Remember, MF is the quotient of X cross I and disjoint union Y by the identification X comma 1 is identified with its image FX inside Y. We also knew that Y itself is a strong deformation retract of MF. Now this result says that if F is homotopy equivalence, then X is a deformation retract of MF. Suppose you assume X is deformation retract of MF. X to MF, you have a deformation, you know, homotopy equivalence. MF to Y, you have a homotopy equivalence. The composite will be homotopy equivalence, then that is precisely F. Inclusion map followed by whatever you have got F at is identity, is equal to F. We have seen that, right? So one way is clear, that it's a deformation retract, then F must be homotopy equivalence. The converse, okay? How do you prove the converse? I have already given you here the proof of one way, namely, an inclusion map is homotopy equivalent, is the same thing as it is a deformation retract. Okay, inclusion map followed by F at is F. What is F at? F at is a strong deformation retract from retraction from MF to Y. So it is a composite will be homotopy equivalence. Okay, so let us prove the converse. If F is homotopy equivalence, then again from this part of theorem A, inclusion map 4.3 will be homotopy equivalence. Because F is I composite, what? f hat. The other way around, f hat composite I, right? Whatever. So if two of them are homotopy equivalence, see, the third one is a homotopy equivalence. I think this is one of the exercises, the very beginning. Hopefully you have done that exercise by now. Now you combine part of D in 4.3 with theorem 4.4, the one which we have just seen, to conclude that X-ray deformation retract of MF. Inclusion map is homotopy equivalence. What are these? This just means that inclusion map of X in MF is a cofibration. This was one of the results, part D of theorem 4.3. And the previous theorem says, if it's a cofibration and a weak deformation retract, then it's a deformation retract. Weak deformation retract, same thing as inclusion map is homotopy equivalence. Okay, I repeat, once inclusion map is homotopy equivalence, okay, and it is a cofibration, then it is a deformation retract. So this was the theorem that we just proved here. A, B, C, three parts of that theorem, right? So use that. So we get the corners here. So corollary is proved, namely, if something is homotopy equivalence between two spaces, the same thing as saying that the domain is deformation retract of the mapping cylinder. Now we come to another. All landmark results in homotopy theory. Two spaces are homotopy equivalent if and only if there is another space W which contains both of them as deformation retracts. This is not just for fun. Sometimes there is no other way to show that a space, two given spaces are homotopy equivalent. This theorem is used deep in differential topology, namely in cobordism theory. Lot of hypothesis is there. With that, you want to construct a homotopy between X and Y. They are manifolds. What you do with them, that inclusion maps, you construct a cobordism between them. Then you show that inclusion maps are deformation retracts. Homotopy equivalences plus, you know that in the case of manifolds, they are cofibrations also. Therefore, because of this theorem, X and Y will be homotopy equivalent. Okay, so one way is obvious, but here we are insisting that you are not losing anything, you are not doing anything great. It is if and only if. This will always happen. So that if and only if part is what we have seen. Okay, if F to X, Y, Y is homotopy equivalence, you take W to be the mapping cylinder, and we have already seen. Okay. Inclusion map followed by F hat composite inclusion map is F. Now F is homotopy equivalence, F hat is homotopy equivalence, so I will be homotopy equivalence. That's all. I have proved the converse here, no? What is the statement here? What is the converse? Converse is obvious, I haven't written down here. The converse is obvious. Why? Because X2W is homotopy equivalence, and Y2W is homotopy equivalence means there is an inverse map from W to Y. You compose the two, that's all. Okay. So this W could be anything. But to get to one, you have to take, if this is homotopy equivalence, you take W to be MF. It need not be MF always. It could be something bigger also, something smaller also. Doesn't matter. If it's a property that inclusion maps are homotopy equivalences from both X and Y, then F will be a homotopic polynomial. That is the whole idea. The X and Y will be homotopic, equivalent. There is no F given, you see. You have to construct one. But if F is given, then you take MFS, space W, that's all. Now we will get some more, you know, some more results. Take a co-vibration, X to Z, okay? So I have changed the notation. Usually A to X I have taken. Now X to Z is co-vibration. Every time I am assuming it says closed subset, okay? X to Z is a closed subspace. Then for every continuous map F from X to Y, the inclusion map of Y into the adjunction space, okay, is a co-vibration. What is adjunction space of F? F is from X to Y, so it is Z disjoint union Y. Points of X are identified with points of Y through F. F and X of X and F of X are identified. That is the adjunction space, right? The adjunction space of F always contains Y as a subspace. Z may not be a subspace, X may not be a subspace because F may not be injective, right? Y to AF, which is an inclusion map, that becomes a co-vibration. Under X to Z is co-vibration. Okay, this is like, now suppose X is X to Y is an inclusion map, okay? Then extending the co-vibration here, from X to Y. Okay. So X to Z was a co-vibration. Y to AF, the larger one, becomes a co-vibration. So it's more general than that. This X need not be a subspace of Y. It's for any map. Any map. So that is the importance of homotopy theory. Okay. So again, co-vibration, what you have to do, you can't go on verifying it for homotopy extension property for all sort of spaces. You have a ready-made proposition there, 4.1, namely, show that A cross I union X cross 0 is a retract of X cross I. In this case, what you have to show, Y cross I union AF cross 0 is a retract of AF cross I. That is what you have to show. So it's very easy. From corresponding hypothesis that X2 is a co-vibration, what I get? Z cross 0 union X cross I is a retract of Z cross I. Okay, so this proposition says first we get a deformation, okay, retract. Just a retract is good enough, then it will become a deformation retract, is what we have seen already. So just a retract is enough. Retract X Z cross I to Z cross 0 in X cross I. Retract means what? On this subspace, it is identity. Now you just define Z disjoint union Y cross I. Remember, the adjunction space was defined as quotient of Z disjoint union Y. Right? So, if you want to construct some map, you go back to the mother space here. With certain extra property, you have to define a map so that it goes down to the quotient space. So here I am using the fact that the product I am taking is a compact space, namely interval. Therefore, whether you take first the quotient here, then take product, or first take the product and then quotient, they are same. This was one of the fundamental result we have proved and we are using it several times now. Okay, so I am defining it on Z cross Z disjoint in Y to I, Z cross 0 union X cross I, disjoint union Y cross I. Okay, here later on, points of X will be identified with Fx. Same thing will be done here. The second factor I, there is no problem there. So this must be the Euler font I here. Okay. So R restricted to Z cross I, Z disjoint in Y cross I, Z cross I disjoint in Y cross I. Okay. You take it as your R here, this ready-made function is here. On Y cross I, you take the identity over. After that, you have to check that it goes down to define a map from AF cross I to AF cross 0, this part will be AF cross 0, union Y cross I. On Y cross I, you have already taken identity. Okay. So, if you try to prove this one directly, you will see how difficult it is, the thing, proving homotopy extension property. I am not saying that it is not possible, all right? But here, this proposition 4.1 makes the life very easy. Okay, finally, the homotopy invariance of what? Of adjunction spaces. Take X to Z, a cofibration. Where Z is a, where X is a closed subset of Z. Two functions F and G from X to Y, I am going to make adjunction spaces. If these two maps are homotopic, then the adjunction spaces are homotopy equivalent. Indeed, a stronger statement is true, namely, as relative pairs AF, Y, AG, Y, Y is a common subspace here. Okay? AF, Y, AG, Y, as a pair are homotopy equivalent. This was done right in the beginning, remember. What is the meaning of this? There is a homotopy, there is a map from AF to AG, okay, which is identity on Y. Similarly, AG to AF, which is identity on Y, these two are homotopy equivalent relative to Y. Okay, so that is a strong statement, namely, adjunction spaces do not depend on exactly what F is, but only depend on the homotopy class of F. So this helps a lot in doing function in homotopy theory. Often you start picking up a map here, but you don't pick up the map. You are actually interested in the homotopy class of that map. And then you want to do something, but then you want to say that whatever you have picked up, you know, it may induce something, another one if you pick something else, no. Adjunction space, as far as it's concerned, the homotopy type hasn't changed. So this is a very useful result. So let us go to the proof of this one. Start with the homotopy, X cross I to Y. Okay, from F to G. We claim that, now you can define adjunction space of H, of this H itself. What is it? It is Z cross I, disjoint union Y, X cross I, points of X cross I being identified with their image under H. Okay, so that is H. So that will also contain Y. Okay, so what we are saying is, AF Y is a pair, is a topological pair, and AG Y, another topological pair, both are subspaces of that. The inclusion maps are homotopy equivalence is enough to say that they will be homotopy equivalent. But what we are saying is they are deformation retracts.
Hello, sir.
Huh?
Yes, can you say one more time how you made AH? I mean, yes, how, what is AH?
AH is adjunction space of H.
Yes, you...
adjunction space is defined for every map.
Yes, I mean, you used Z cross I, right?
Yeah.
Of course, okay.
Because X
okay.
cross I is not contained inside Z, it's Z cross I.
Okay.
So that will come. I have just only claimed here, I just that explanations will come now, huh?
Okay.
Okay. What is AH? This is the picture. See, this is Y. This Y here, huh? This is Y here. X is a single point I have chosen in the diagram. This circle is your Z. Okay. You get it? X first goes to this point. And then this Y is chosen as a path. It goes to this point. And its homotopy means it is a path here. Right? A homotopy of a point is nothing but a path. In the picture, I have to only take the simplest cases. Okay. So the first point is F, the end point is G. When singleton X is a singleton, map is nothing but the point, right? Now a homotopy is nothing but a path here. Here I have taken AG, AF here. This is Y. Disjoint union Z, but X is identified with its image. Is it clear?
Okay.
In this picture, I have taken AG. I want to say both of them are subspaces of AH here. What is AH? It is from Z cross I. X cross I identified with its image here. You see,
yes, sir.
Cross I is not a straight line now, right? It is, you have to take the path, whatever path the capital H is. So this is the adjunction space for H. Now, is this picture is clear? Now, what I have to show is this part is subspace here, and that is subspace there, okay? They are deformation retracts.
Okay.
All right. The argument is exactly symmetrical. If I show one of them is deformation retract, other one will be also deformation retract for the same reason. In fact, there is a T factor. You have to reverse T to 1 minus T, then the role of X cross 0 and Z cross 0 and Z cross 1 will be interchanged, that's all. So this part is Z cross 1 here, this is Z cross 0 when you take the homotopy here. Okay. You see, we are actually doing much more than cobordism theory. This looks like a cobordism when things are manifold. Here, they are not even manifolds, but we have cobordism kind of things here. Okay, so these results will be used in very deep differential topology. So here is a proof. Finally, you have to write down proof. This is the idea. Again, by this 4.1, what is the assumption? Assumption is X is a cofibration. X to Z is a cofibration. That is a standing assumption. So I have a retraction Z cross I, to Z cross 0 in X cross I. Okay? This induces a deformation retraction R naught bar, okay, from AH, which is the adjunction space for H. y union over h z cross 0 union x cross i. Okay, let q be y disjoint union z cross 0 union x cross I to y disjoint union z cross 0 and x cross I. This is the quotient space. This is disjoint union. This is the ordinary union where this identification is taken place. Its restriction q1 to z disjoint union z cross 0, forget about this part, that is a surjective map. Okay. Moreover, for any F, a closed subspace contained in the Y union this part, check that Q inverse of this one is Q inverse of F union H inverse of Y intersection F. This part I have written down only for people who have forgotten that the product of quotients, you know, first take quotient and then product with the identity map. When I is compact, it's a quotient first, it's the first take the product and then the quotient. This part is not needed for you now because I have actually proved that one. But here I am actually proving that it's a quotient map. Okay. So therefore, what you get is that Q prime is a quotient map after taking the product. Therefore, this part is nothing but Y union over F, Z cross 0, because X cross I part is just hanging around there, goes into this one. So that's AF. Okay. So this will show you that AF is a deformation. This part, what is this part? This was deformation retract. So that's AF is what it is. Y union H. This was a deformation retract. Now this I showed that it is equal to AF. Okay, so there is some, it will take some time to understand why such things work. Okay, you will get lost in notations here. Proof is, this picture is, tells you what is going to happen. Once you have proved that AF is deformation retract, AG deformation retract is just changing T2 and minus T. Symmetric argument. Okay, so you can stop here.